Welcome to Wayne Scrobney Talks for the Superstars. Tonight, Wayne's guest, the incredible.
What's up? Yo, we on live Morris Media,
yeah.
live.com. I guess if you on here, you already know that.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, thanks everybody. Welcome to Mike Robertson Boulevard and the place to be.
What's happening?
What's happening, y'all?
Hey.
Chisnilling.
Mm-hmm.
Chisnilling like villains.
In here.
Mm-hmm.
Right. All right. Well, let's get to the right to my great cohorts. Is that a word? I don't even know.
Cohorts?
It is
cohorts.
Now.
It is now, huh?
Cohorts?
I don't know.
It's cracking.
To the right of me, I got Mr. Mellroz Uncut.
Melly Mel,
a.k.a.
A.k.a. the
Mel
bougie
Blunt,
shopper.
The bougie shopper, huh? Show EBT up.
Yeah. Mellroz went live with the little...
Tyrese Challenge.
Yeah, Tyrese Challenge. That shit was dope.
Yeah, fuck
y'all ain't
Tyrese
see it.
Challenge.
That shit was live. next to me to the left, I have my lovely sister, Miss Precious, in the place to be, Oak Cliff to Hollywood. Hashtag
Big Diddy.
It, baby.
What up, though?
Say you was there.
Yo,
what
man?
Up, though? You good?
Chilling. I'm good. I'm great. I feel good.
How many days you on your challenge?
I am 9 days in, so a little over a week. You
man,
know what I'm saying?
Get with the challenge. Every day, you hitting Runyon Canyon every day?
That's when it's not raining, I am.
Oh, when it's not raining?
Yeah.
Oh, it ain't rain, sleet, or snow?
In the gym, you
You're
know
not with
saying?
The rain, sleet, or snow?
Nah. I'm black. I'm still black. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to get it in.
You're not a postal worker.
You know what I'm saying?
She stay faithful to the challenges, too.
Yeah. You stick with your shit like 30 days, 60 days.
Yeah.
She's inspiring. They can wake up like, I hope Fred's out there working out. I'm going to watch her.
Yeah, I'm going to watch her and shit. Yeah. Maybe sweat a little bit.
I lived on Facebook. Precious would put on a fire truck. Like,
she pulling a fire truck?
That was day four.
That was day four.
I am trying to work on the tongue. You know how you can be a cool size, but you want that little, just the little shit to show when you like get a point out, and they like, oh, that bitch is like a little
Michelle
bit.
Obama arms.
She got arms, baby.
Okay. We working on it.
Next to her, I got Dwann Brown in the place to be, Mr. Sports and Things.
That's me, Sports and
Live
Things.
Live MC and everything like that. What's up, buddy?
I'm good, man. How y'all doing?
We
y'all
straight, doing? Man. Dwann Brown was absent last week. He had the flu.
Man, that was some bush.
Flu action, man. What was up with that, man?
Man, I'm like,
you get a flu shot?
Hey, fuck them flu shots.
Okay, I'm just making sure.
Yeah, fucking with no flu shots.
Shit.
I ain't never had
one.
This is my first time getting flu. My first time getting a flu in 20 years.
Really?
My first time getting flu in 20 years. I'm good, you know what I mean? But like, I was on your thing, Precious. Like, my fat ass trying to lose weight, you know what I mean? So I be going on these walks.
Weight. Yeah.
So I walk.
You got the flu from a walk?
I be walking like 5-6 miles a day.
See, I ain't doing
and
that.
And then like last week, 2 weeks ago, I was like, you know what? It's about to rain, but I got to get it in.
See? Type shit. That's why I don't do this.
That's why you don't do that,
I started to
huh?
get it in, and I'm walking down El Segundo, and I'm like halfway around Hawthorne Airport, and I can't walk back, and it started raining.
Start pouring on your ass.
How many walks did you do? Like, how many walks were you into the walks?
I was like, I'm 3 months in now.
Okay.
Like 4 or 5 days a week.
Official.
At least 5 miles. Yeah. You know what I mean?
And that's so good, because I think the thing I do at rain is maybe 2, right? The big hill, maybe 2 miles. But that's great.
The loop is 3. It's 1.5 one way and back.
Oh, it's 1.5.
1.5 each way. Like, like if you just went one way, you know, from like the bottom to the top.
Yeah.
It's 1.5.
Just don't do that shit in the rain, man, because I was looking weak as fuck.
I was on my way this morning.
I was looking like Michael Bibbins in that BBD video. You know what
nigga,
I mean?
All
nigga
wet.
Said, I apologize, nigga.
It's
big
raining.
Suit, knocking it over. Like,
that was that shit, too.
That was a shit, though, but I was looking weak.
I thought you was around like some little kids or something, man, working at a daycare center or something, dude.
Nah, man, when them kids be coughing, I get them the fuck out of my face.
I used to get the flu all the time, dude. It was crazy.
Yeah, they rain. Can't
fuck with that shit.
Be careful when you're out there on your walks.
Look. Mm-hmm.
Niggas throwing drive-by flus at you and shit.
Flu on the walk.
Drive-by fluism.
Yeah, don't let me get it. I'm going to pass it on for sure. I'm going to get the flu and be right up in the comedy club.
All on the mic.
Right on the mic, dude. Like, whoever get it, going to get it.
You know what I'm saying? Rain, Shalita, Snow. Passing that shit around.
Come get these jokes.
Dang, man. I used to have this little cocktail I used to make, man. That shit was cool, man. I used to put all kind of shit up in there. Like, I put some hot ass tea, and I put like some hen rock or something brown up in it. Then I put a couple little drops, little cough drops in it, and let that shit dissolve in it like it's lean, but it ain't lean.
Right.
Put my little candy in it, and man, bundle up, put a sweatshirt on in the bed, and drink that shit, man, in the morning. I'm good. Sweat the fuck.
That's old school hot toddy.
That's a hot toddy.
Grandma
exactly.
Been making them forever.
Right. That's where I learned it from. I about the medicine, and I just thought they put the lemon, the liquor.
Right, and the lemon.
And the tea. Yeah, something like lemon.
Lemon, tea, and drink. That's it. And
little lean,
it
dude. You got to put a little bit of NyQuil.
With some hen or something.
Yeah. With some hen.
The NyQuil, that's early lean right there. That's
early lean. Yeah, that's beginnings of lean right there.
Beginning lean.
Ooh, that NyQuil good, boy. You know what? When you be broke or something, like in college, we'll pop some NyQuil. I'm just saying, that was back in the day. But you know what I'm saying? You be loaded off that shit. You got to stay up. You know what I'm saying? So you fucked up. You know what I'm saying? But we had the real lean.
You had this. Sipping on some scissor herbs. Sip, sip,
yeah.
Sip.
Codeine with permit.
With the whole, you know the ingredients.
If it ain't wit, Cody, wit, Prometheus.
You know. All right, you gotta have a real activist.
Yeah, people like her.
Motherfuckers be spending like a G on that shit, man. I didn't know it cost that much.
Like
this motherfucker was like, dude, this cup right here, man, cost it's $500 in this cup. I was like, what the fuck?
Man, I don't get that.
In one cup,
I don't get getting high to go to sleep.
Yeah, dude, how do you
at least when you smoke weed, you can do some shit. Because
the point is to fight it. You know what I'm saying? The point is, the dudes be leaned out. But the point is, even though I'm like out of it, like I'm still.
Yeah, niggas think they should really be on this shit.
That's what my people was doing. Like the shit you saying, like this is what my brother was doing back in college days. Like, woo, see, check out this cup. Like it's muddy as fuck. Like, you know, because it's mostly syrup, little.
Yeah, a little Sprite and everything.
Yeah, but it was. Because in the South, we do downer drugs, you know, like syrup, like
downer drugs.
Xanax, you know, shit to have you slow. You know what I'm saying?
That's why y'all music be sounding so smooth.
Exactly.
And you feel smooth.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what we
I guess if it's like 900 goddamn degrees in Atlanta, ain't nothing, you can't do shit till 8 p.m. anyway, so you may as well go to sleep.
Nigga, the mosquitoes is out at 8, though. So
yeah,
be careful, nigga. Just sigh.
That's not an L.A. thing, man. We smoke weed and get active. You know what I mean? That's the hell we do.
That's what we do.
Yeah, I gotta snort a line and get active. Snort a line, be on some upper drugs.
But how do you
get that? Meanwhile,
yeah.
I'm high and stuck.
That's
like,
that other shit.
That's the bullshit they do. We on Crenshaw, though.
That's
yeah.
East of Vermont, west of Century. That shit everywhere.
Man, are niggas still smoking crack? That's what I don't know about. Is that? That's gotta be over. Oh, hey, Dwann, you
the white folks from Lamar Odom was doing it, wasn't he?
Oh, that nigga Lamar Odom was.
No, nah, he wasn't doing crack.
What was
niggas
he doing?
On meth.
Oh,
now.
He was doing crack? Not crack? He had one level crack.
Dude, he jugged him out. He always got to say it twice. Like,
crack?
Hey.
Okay. All right. So, we're going to talk about what's trending first, right? Went on Twitter today, see what's trending.
What's trending, Mike?
It should be changing, dude, like all day. So, I locked into a specific moment in time, which was about like 5 hours ago, because a nigga might get on and be like, nigga, that ain't trending no more. What's trending earlier? First one. Trending. Hashtag Obama farewell.
It's gotta be trending right now. Mm-hmm.
Gotta be
that
trending.
That wasn't 5
majorly.
Hours ago, was it? Yeah, it was trending.
No. Well, that was 5. Yeah, exactly. It's been kind of like half the day.
I'm not gonna lie.
5 months this nigga been.
I ain't gonna lie. I watched it, y'all, and I'm not even gonna lie. I did get a little teary eyed. You know what I'm saying? Because right when I was getting into it, like I was listening, you know how you be moving around.
Right.
Right when I was getting into it was right when he hollered at Michelle, and I was like, oh, you know, like you got the church chill bumps, like, oh shit. He like, and my wife and everybody up, and she like, you know, and he like, oh, it was just so, yeah,
it was
just
lovely,
touched my
huh?
soul. Yeah, and then like they really did represent, you know what I'm saying, us as a people, just
For sure,
in
man.
A great light, like they really did represent us well. I don't give a fuck what the daughter did. Let her go have some fun.
I know, man.
They really
I know.
Did.
Smoke a little. They I don't brought give a class. Fuck. I smoke. Shit. So what? Still living my dream.
Exactly.
Shit, you know what I'm saying?
I hope it was the chronic. I hope you wasn't smoking no stress. That DC backyard Boogie Brown shit.
Nah, she had that shit. Trust me. She had the presidential.
She be fucking with she had the presidential.
On your ass. Yes,
on your ass. She be fucking with Chance the Rapper and niggas like that. I'm sure he slid her a nice little package.
Oh, come on, man. Don't do her like that, man.
Yeah, he slid her a package, all right?
She got caught, man. Just already, I ain't doing nothing to her. It's on blast. They got her on video and on camera and on Instagram. She smoking some bud.
Yeah, smoking some bud and then just that kicking already. It. But I be kicking it too. Look at her like she fine as hell, like her mama, like
that's,
she slim.
That's a step above the preacher's daughter, fine. Nigga.
She ultimate. That's like Jesus' daughter, above, nigga.
Nigga, on the level of freaking.
I wish I
happen.
Would be the president. Bring me the presidential.
Yeah, bring me the presidential.
Was it like? Was like this his last speech?
This is last speech as president.
Tonight. Yeah, it was so good.
Man, I was feeling it. I was feeling it because, man, he just brought so much class to the White House, dude, and, like, respect and, like, beauty and power.
Coolness, dog. Just a regular dude that's really, like, doing my job.
Just keep it real. He brought that black.
He brought that black swag to the White House.
Yeah, he brought the black.
I'm coughing because it's a bunch of bullshit.
This nigga, I know. All right, look, we got a caller. We're going to get into his whatever that bullshit is in a second. Caller, you say what?
Yo, what's up, my brother Mike? This bitch Bill Crump hollering at you.
What's up? What's up, homie? How you doing, man?
I'm fantastic, man. Fantastic.
We talking about Obama. Did you check that shit out, man? Did you watch it?
I did. You know, it was real touching, real heartfelt. I mean, it kind of watered me up a little bit, man. And, you know,
I niggas got watered up.
But yeah, exactly. So,
what didn't you like about the speech, though? What struck you the wrong way?
Nothing struck me the wrong way about it because I actually agreed with everything that he said.
Wow.
Right. I mean, all of the philosophies and the beliefs about the country, that's just all me. And so he was just clicking on all cylinders. And that's what touched me about it because I was hoping the rest of the people received it as well as I did. Mm.
Right. Mm-hmm. Damn. Well, I know I did, man. I was feeling it, dude, because once again, dude, we're going to go from him to about 15 more less motherfuckers, dude, to come in the near future. And it's going to be a long time coming before we get some coolness back up in that joint. So
absolutely,
I was feeling it.
Absolutely.
I was feeling it, man.
One of the things that I left with is that it almost felt like he was leaving us a message that, you know, we got some rough times ahead of us.
Oh, yes.
You know.
Whether he said it or not.
Yeah. He looked it more hurt. Because he was leaving and really hoped that we understood his message. And so that's definitely what I got out of it.
Wow.
Even he almost teared up. You know what I'm saying? He had to bring out his handkerchief one time. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Did you see him? Like
that.
When he was talking about Michelle, too, he had to bring it out like...
I saw that.
Man, and Michelle be looking fine, too, man. I know we talked about this on an earlier show, but my sister improved over these 4 years. That's what I'm about to say, because 8 years.
Right.
Yeah.
Thank
definitely
you for
did. She looked the part. You know, she got us eating right, too, man, because, you know, even in down in Inglewood, man, where we from, she even had the vegetable stores and the fruit stores and the stands and stuff like that.
Yeah, she implemented that in the school.
Niggas still
too,
going
right?
There and buy hot Cheetos, nigga.
That part.
Yeah, that part. All right, man. Thanks for calling in, my man.
Absolutely.
Much love,
man.
Dog.
Much love.
100.
Hey, our number is 323-293-3375. 323-293-3375.
Yeah.
Call in. Yeah, so I thought it was cool. Dwann, what you got to say on it?
It was a good speech. Like, when it comes... to symbolism, when it comes to the look of the presidency and speeches, President Obama is one of the best of all time. Probably the best of all time. My only problem is, when you hire a president, their job is to create policy, not to make me feel good. That's what I got Dr. Phil for, goddammit. My thing is, your job, when bankers say, hey, we need some laws changed in our way, they don't say give me a speech. They say give me some policy. So when it come to us as black folks, I mean, we was getting shot left and right. Left and right. And I'm talking about, I ain't talking about things he could have did with Congress, because Congress wasn't fucking with him. I get that.
That's
Congress
right.
Congress was not dealing with Obama. I understand that. That was a roadblock. But what did President Bush 1 do when he's right? When Rodney King got his ass beat here in L.A., what did he do? He said, Department of Justice, go and sick and something on them, and let's find out what's going wrong with the LAPD. And when they did that, you know what happened? We ended up having the whole crash unit disbanded. We fired our police chief. Our police chief used to be like an incumbent job. It changed to where now they have to become elected every 4 years. You know what I mean? What else did he do?
Credit to George Bush for all of
no,
that?
The reason why I'm giving him credit is because what he did was when black people who are taxpaying citizens of the United States get police brutality.
Some of them.
That's a violation of your 5th and 14th Amendment rights. What's the 5th and 14th Amendment? Equal protection under the law and due process under the law.
When we going to step up and do something about
it's
it,
it's not about stepping it up and doing something about it.
We got to step up and do something about it,
You know what happened? I'm talking about the policies the president has.
I'm talking about the policies on my block,
nigga.
He
could have done.
What I'm saying is when we have inherent police corruption, which they found in Ferguson, which they found in Tampa, Florida, you can seek the Department of Justice on to bring charges against those police departments to have them rectify those situations because of violation of rights. He didn't do that. And that's something that got happened over and
over
again.
So that's a miss.
Yeah, I'm saying, but I'm black, so I'm worried about getting killed by the police. You know, like.
Yeah, but when we going to step
no,
up,
no,
man?
No, no, it's not about, no, no.
When niggas what be on the corner choking people out, dude, on the sidewalk and stuff, we going to wait for the president
those
to come.
Those are sorry niggas doing
up,
that.
Dude.
Those are sorry niggas doing that.
Got to step up.
What's his name? Is a social worker like me and got shot with his hands on the ground. What was he doing? He was at
but
work.
Where's people's at? Where the block at? Where them hard ass niggas from his hood at? Where they at?
Out my face. My thing is this.
Please, man.
Your
man,
job
we gotta stop
is
waiting. We got to stop
you
waiting.
Have policies, the things that you can do to rectify to make sure that all American citizens have their 5th and 14th Amendment rights honored. And we didn't get that as black people with the black president. We got that under previous presidents where they were at least send an investigation down there like, what's something going on? Let's fix it.
That nigga investigated Ferguson.
Man,
what came out of that?
We talking about how the nigga looked in the office, man. Not what he did.
Yeah, how he is. He has some nice suits.
No, he did do something.
You can pick it apart, dude, and figure out what he didn't do that you didn't like. I got issues. I went to a black college. I had an issue with the fact that maybe it wasn't a different initiative for black
colleges. What does that have to do with your constitutional rights, though? I'm talking about constitution.
All our rights are being abused.
I'm talking about the Constitution.
Yeah, it ain't the only one.
If your rights are being abused and you're voting, why are you voting for someone to continue to abuse their constitutional rights?
Hey,
when I go to Subway, I want a sandwich. I don't want to feel good. So when I go to the polls, I want policy, not to feel good. You feel me?
Well, you should not vote, dude, if you're dissatisfied.
No,
bro.
I vote. No, I do what's called a smart vote. When that means
vote locally.
I'm going to vote locally.
You got to vote locally.
But nationally, if a politician wants my vote, they have to at least say something to me to speak to my needs.
Understood.
Like everyone else who gets what they want. Because gay people didn't say give me a speech. They said we want to get married, motherfucker. And 2 years later, it happened.
And they fought for it.
Yeah, exactly. And I fought. And a lot of black people like me, we may not get news coverage,
steps,
but
nigga,
it's plenty of us fighting for equal justice under the law when it comes to police protection. We just don't have microphones in front of us.
Oh,
and
I wish he was Obama, Houdini. Nigga could put any policy in place you want. They still going to do that
I don't play the general any. I'm talking about specific 5th and 14th Amendment rights. I just want to know my police officer, if he shoot me, his ass can go to jail just like right down the street. That's all I want to know.
Hey, I want to know if my police police officer shoot me, that nigga's going to get at him. That's what I want to know about.
That's not going to happen. And if they do get at him,
in my family, that's how
they drop bombs on them motherfuckers like they did in Philadelphia with them move bombs.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, it's a fight.
Kill all your black asses.
It's a fight. Shit. All right, next one. Dillon Roof. Y'all know who that is, right?
The dude that shot
9 people in South Carolina. He's trending. He got the death penalty. Got sentenced today. That's some good shit.
Yeah.
No?
I wouldn't even say alive.
You want to see him alive?
Yeah, I want to see him alive. Let him live. He wanted to die. Don't give him what he wants.
He going
to
live a long time. You know how they put him on
the death penalty.
He going to get a lot of time. He already got attacked. He already got gang raped in jail. He need that about 10 more times, but he going to get it.
Dillon Roof, that boy right there.
That motherfucker. Yeah. And they were nice to him too, man. That's the worst part
about
it.
They gave him Burger King.
Yeah, they gave him Burger King on the way to jail, dude. When did you get that treatment?
Yeah, like, great job. You hungry?
Yeah, man, you look hungry. You look nice.
Yeah.
Y'all could use a Whopper.
He didn't get socked up not one time or nothing. Well, the same with the dude that shot up
airport.
That Batman movie that came out, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Dark Knight 2 or whatever that shit was.
I got a question. Why in the hell, when them kids was over in Baltimore after the Freddie Gray thing, when they was out there supposedly riding, President Obama came out and had a whole speech to the black community, what the black community needs to get done. But he didn't say shit to the white community with all these white folks killing innocent folks. He didn't say, hey, white people, maybe you need to stop going on drugs and doing all this and take care of your kids.
Oh, man.
But we got that out of Baltimore. Why the fuck all black
people?
They
have it both ways.
No. I wanted both. No, we didn't get it both ways. That's the problem. Why do I got to get a speech? Because Ray Ray fucked up.
Ray Ray always fucking
yeah,
up.
Yeah, that nigga always fucking up.
Dillon Roof fucked up. It's like, oh, he was a bad actor. White community, keep going ahead.
You know
fine.
What's going on, man.
Man, you know, dude, exactly. You live in like a fantasy, you know what I mean? Because
no, I live in reality, man.
Shit, you're living a wishful reality. Wishful, it ain't the truth.
You're right, that's the problem.
Yeah, exactly, it is.
It is wishful.
All right, the next one. This dude, there's a movie out trending called The Bye-Bye Man. Y'all heard of that shit?
No.
The Bye-Bye Man. That shit sound weak. Basically, it's coming out on Friday the 13th. It's a horror movie. And the way they describe it is he is the evil behind man's most unspeakable acts. And then it also says, the slogan on the poster said, you won't be laughing when he kills you.
Scary.
Scary.
Scary, yo.
Scary, yo.
What is this about?
Scary, yo.
I don't know. It's a fucking scary movie, dude.
That's scary, yo.
Scary, yo.
Scare me
you
to
won't
death.
Be laughing at the end of this motherfucking movie, I
when
tell you
when you die
that.
Going to your car.
How about that one? Put on yeah. these 3D glasses that you want to. In there.
Yeah. Wait, let me do one more before we take a break. The next one, hashtag golden showers is trending. Are y'all up on that?
The real gold? Or what?
The real gold? So here's the story. Donald Trump was in Russia in a hotel, and he stayed in the same hotel Obama and Michelle stayed in, and he had such a dislike for Michelle Obama that he hired a bunch of prostitutes and let him stand on the bed, and he did lemonade showers on his bed, on that bed that she slept on, that they slept in, and they got it on tape and they got audio.
Trump doing
Trump.
This? For real?
I'm
for
not
real.
Surprised.
I know. I want to
on
be
the
surprised.
News. Saw that. I know, huh?
But the thing about it is, it's almost like a so what. He's white, man. People keep trying to hold Trump
some
to,
type of
yeah, like come on,
yeah,
man.
He's not. You can't.
That's the white man. They do anything,
what
man.
Do?
Yeah.
I'm the
and
white
then
man.
He gonna put it in your face, and then nobody gonna do nothing.
And then say it wasn't like that. And
yeah,
like, right,
they said that
cool.
wasn't even me and shit.
All
right. My cousin, the orangutan.
That's Ben Stiller.
A president hired prostitutes. Yeah,
you said orangutan.
Well, the president's wife is a prostitute. Well, the new president coming in.
That's true. That's true.
I wonder how much
she
paid.
She's gonna be suing. She said she threatened to sue comedians and people who call her a prostitute, the new
yeah,
first lady.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Blah, blah, blah.
That's Donald Trump.
She got,
nuts.
She got hired on Backpage and talking about and getting mad that we found out.
Exactly.
Your pictures don't even look classy, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Like, you could have did better than that. Like, we can do better yeah, bootleg exactly. pictures than that, bitch. You just standing there with your stupid
shitty
looking ass.
Looking like a microphone stand and fancy bathing suits and shit.
Yeah, with man. Coconuts.
He's who Ice Cube was rapping about when he wrote Cave Bitch. He was writing, talking about her.
Ah, man, on that note, man, we're about to take a quick music break. We'll be right back, y'all.
I smoke it now. You open to disease and cold. And ain't 16 years old. This shit has got to stop. Let's take a
We was just talking about how CeeLo had the little phone blow up on his earpiece. the Samsung, but that shit was not even real. Word on the
allegedly.
Screen. Allegedly.
Allegedly not
right.
real.
That nigga could not be. What show was he on? The Voice and shit? Was he on?
Was I think he was on The Voice.
Oh.
CeeLo, wasn't he?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. For
he
a
was
minute.
On The
he
Voice.
Was. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, he ain't on there
he used
no
to
more.
Have a cat on there rubbing that motherfucker. sitting that there nigga. On his lap.
Like a mob
that
boss.
The Andre 3000 of...
He's amazing.
Goody mob.
He just got some short arms. He like that's the bottom part of
so
your
he arm. Do have some yeah, short arms. He do have some like midget Tennessees and shit.
Yeah, some.
Some. He dope with them lyrics though.
Yes, he is.
Yeah.
So we left off on the Golden Showers by Trump. So so after the Golden Showers happened, what immediately became a trending moment is, I mean, trending is R. Kelly. So there's like 20,000 new posts about R. Kelly now agreeing to play at the inauguration. He respects Trump's piss game and shit. He wanna like niggas wanna pee on
piss for a piss,
pee
bro.
On me? R. Kelly is trending. I don't know if he liked that or not.
I fucks with Kelly.
I don't mean to interrupt, but I did just see that they kind of tripping off of Sasha not being there. You know what I'm saying? Like ooh. The internet is kind of
where she at?
Going she in. She wasn't there. It was just them and
I wonder where she is.
She's probably getting high, man. Leave her alone.
I don't know, but they putting shit.
Oh
like,
wait, is Sasha's the one that's
you
saw
this when you saw you in your teens? You ain't trying to be around your parents like that.
Sasha, they said
Sasha the older one, right?
They being for no, that's the younger.
No,
one.
Malia.
Malia is the oldest one. She was there.
I don't tell
that's the one who was getting in trouble.
She's the one that was blazing, I think.
Blazing, dancing, kicking it.
Yeah, dancing.
But Sasha, was chilling. Somebody was on there like, can I get Thursday night out? I mean, Tuesday night off. My dad is giving his farewell speech. Manager, only if you can find someone to cover your shift.
That's all it be,
going
though.
In.
That's
yeah.
all it be.
They talking about when the tickets is so far, you can only get two for the fam.
Oh, damn.
You want to stay at home, baby. You got she like, keep... I ain't want to go to that bullshit anyway.
I got to work. I'm on the clock at the Waffle House.
Yeah, but
Cracker Barrel.
Ticket so far, you only get two.
Look, I only got a plus one.
Yeah. A plus one. Niggas be forging the stamp and shit.
Nah. And they cost too much.
I'm sure she's probably out of the country studying abroad or doing something major. Yeah. Yes. The only reason. Yes. Yeah.
Something major.
Super major.
Super. She on levels to the game. Next one. I don't even care about talking about this. This dude Sessions, Jeff Sessions, Attorney General, that they trying to get, that Trump is appointing. Dude that likes the KKK, says no, nothing wrong with race relations, all that good stuff. Dude is about to be our next Attorney General.
Well,
sounds about right.
Sounds like what we
everything,
have.
Everything back to normal, man.
Sounds like what we going to do right now.
It's as usual. Shit,
everything back to normal.
What has the Department of Justice done for us lately?
Yeah. What we thought was going to happen. What we thought was going to happen.
I know. I don't know, man.
Shit.
I'd rather have, like, Judge Wapner on that motherfucker.
God the white damn. Man is back,
what's
man.
That lady
the
judge name? Man. Judge Judy and shit.
In full effect.
I am back.
I am back. Back from vacation. The next one is Meek Mill is trending. They show video of Meek Mill. I don't have a clip, but Meek Mill was walking out his crib and he slipped down the stairs.
That was
on
him on
ice.
That video?
Yes.
I saw that video.
Meek
I didn't know.
Mill bust his
me.
Ass today.
Well, that's funny. He deserves that, though. He deserves
he
that.
Said, a lot of y'all niggas want to see me fall.
Yeah.
So here it is.
Here we go.
I saw he have on black.
Yeah. He had on black.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Oh my God, I did not know that
he
was Meek Mill.
Bust his ass.
He deserved it. He deserved it.
He blamed it on the Yeezys.
But you know what?
Did he
blame? But did y'all hear about how him and Nicki broke up or whatever?
We heard that, yeah.
And so for him to be like, see, that's the thing I fear right there. Like, you know, you never know who you messing with. And motherfuckers are childish. Like, you love that girl to death and wanted her so bad. Then y'all break up. Now you showing her shoes. Like, don't ever wear these whack. You know what I'm saying? Right, like, right. Now you going in on
Let's
her.
Let's go ahead and just take that and just sit your ass down.
He must have already heard the Nicki Minaj diss record early.
Yeah. He just, unreleased.
These kids got all these damn beta males
Nicki
to look
Minaj
up to, man.
Might go in on
real
him.
Nigga. If you lost, you lost, man. What
yeah,
you getting mad
just
for?
Let
you
it
was,
go.
You was with her and she was good enough to be with for
yeah,
2-3 years.
That's what killed me.
Just take your little L and sit your ass down.
Hey, but look, how it happened, this is at least what I saw, is they was on vacation somewhere on the island or something.
Uh-huh.
And something happened and dude was like, all right, I'm leaving. And he left the island, dude. Left her on vacation. Left her there.
Probably what
was
happened
like,
was
fuck that.
Somebody probably challenged her to a freestyle and she killed him.
Yeah.
And he got embarrassed.
Yeah, or she did.
Happened.
That's what I heard happen. Word on the street.
Me, come on, man.
Chill.
If
what's
that's
up,
what happened,
man?
Then, like, come on, man.
Buster Patrol.
That's how them Philly niggas get down.
Philly niggas. I don't know why this next shit was trending. My kitchen skills include... what the fuck? I don't know. The niggas just talking about what they can cook in the kitchen. What's the best thing they could cook?
Man, fuck that.
Every time they can cook, people can't.
I be making cereal, nigga. And,
people can't
and
make
burgers.
Top ramen with hot dogs. Ain't talking about something they can cook.
Man, dude. I'm a master at top ramen, though, actually, and shit.
My kitchen skills include sex on us. On the stove.
Sex on the stove.
While it's still warm.
While it's burning, the eyes be on.
Cock on the counter.
Yeah.
With the griddle on medium.
Yeah, with the griddle, with the oven door open so your feet
face
can rest.
FaceTime in the fridge.
Ah, that's funny. I don't know. That. I guess you could have them kind of kitchen skills. Maybe it's the back of your neck talking. I don't know. 30. Okay, the next one. 30 plus appreciation. I don't know where that came from, why it got so hot, but niggas appreciating being 30 plus. I guess that's cool.
I like that. That's cool, yeah, because being I've been around 30 is some bullshit, so that's cool.
Man.
I'm with it. I'm with it.
That's age?
That,
yeah, that's age. I guess that's age. 30 unless you're taking 30 hits from the blunt or something. I don't know.
I don't know.
Next one, Solange. Is trending because she got interviewed by Beyonce.
That's
like, that's
dope.
Special.
I think that's
what's
dope.
What's up? Yeah. I didn't see that, but that's what's up.
Yeah, she got interviewed by Beyonce. I still ain't heard the album. Everybody say that shit is bomb. Killer.
I like
man.
It, actually.
I still ain't heard it. I heard it's dope.
I like it. It's dope. It's really
like
dope.
Her writing is like next level.
And she been writing. You know
she
what I'm saying?
Writing,
yeah,
exactly.
She been writing, exactly.
Her shit is
she
next
been
level.
Dope. She been that low key dope, and then it just surfaced. Like,
oh, she been, yeah, exactly. Because Beyonce got all the shine. It's like you look at her and be like, you just singing because you were a little sister, but nah, she really got them skills.
She really got them skills.
And she went at Jay-Z in the elevator.
She
had a few
fuck.
Hands.
She the gangster one.
She had
and,
a few hands.
She a DJ and she write and she
and she got a fro.
Overall dope, you know.
Yep.
And she got a baby.
She had a baby at 17 on your ass.
Yeah,
like
that's what?
What
I'm saying.
Ooh, let's do
she
it.
She been the big little sister. You get it?
Yeah.
Like,
that's
you come
true.
For my sister, I whoop your ass. Yeah, I'm a mama already. Yeah, I did.
Yeah,
you know
exactly.
What I'm saying? Like, bitch, you got me fucked up.
Yeah, because
Beyonce
had.
Auntie, bitch.
Excuse me.
Right. She had Blue Ivy. She was like, bitch, you late.
Yeah.
Ben had a baby. all right, the last one. Kodak Black. Y'all know who that is? Little rapper dude. Kodak Black wants to fight Lil Wayne. Live on pay-per-view, be the undercard for Chris Brown and Soulja Boy. And look, they got a little video of him with stacks of cash in his room, and he like, look,
is
I'm going to put...
Is he the one who be talking all the shit with the money? No.
Yeah.
Is he the one? I don't know.
Is he in the camera?
Yeah. And be like holding it to his ear, his stack to the ear like it's a phone.
Straight nigga shit.
He said he want to fight Lil Wayne, all his money versus all Lil Wayne money. Mm-hmm. Like Big Bank take Lil Bank. I don't know what he's trying to say, but nigga, please.
They need to get all this money.
Boy, sit down. First of all,
come on, new
stop
money.
It, dog.
Come on, new money.
Niggas out here with real life lives and families. You think he could look, all my money, all your money.
Right.
Well, boy, what you think?
What you in the eighth grade?
All you niggas gonna be broken like, about 5 years after your next, after
you
last
know it.
Hit. So,
I'm
what the
hoping
hell?
The fight is still interesting with Soulja Boy and Chris Brown by March. You know what I'm saying? Because right now it's like, do it now. Because y'all not even that big. Yeah. Y'all not Floyd, fool. I don't care if Floyd back in it. You're not my dude. You're not Floyd.
You see you know Soulja Boy doing them workouts and shit?
I know his workouts is whack, dude.
And makes you work out
I'm
terrible.
Working out harder than this nigga.
Yes, go to her Instagram. You're going to see a damn workout.
That nigga is pulling down like 20
like,
pounds, nigga. On
I'm
a,
like, what is he
a,
holding? Two pounds?
Yeah, like, he's curling number two pencils. Talking about something, I'm getting swole.
Wait, a shirt off. Is his shirt off? Oh, my gosh.
Any nigga working out in jeans.
You're killing me.
Treadmill with jeans on.
With his socks. Any nigga riding a treadmill with his socks on is
with skinny jeans and socks on.
With skinny jeans on, dude.
That nigga put them jeans on. He was like, I know what I'm working in. I got some nice tights in here. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Way to put on these stretch pants.
That's
like,
his loose pants, yeah. Say. And they fighting in Dubai. They trying to make it like some thing, man.
Say,
they need to go
to
somebody's barnyard.
I thought they said LA.
Say, no, why are you training, fool? Y'all supposed to be dudes just who got
street gangsters.
Yeah,
nigga.
Where your street
line
game?
It up, nigga.
Say, when you think about it,
line
back
it
in
up.
The day, we ain't never been like, all right, it's a fight. Hello. Two weeks off.
Yeah.
Our boxing gym is like 20 feet that way. They can do it there.
Niggas
it's tomorrow at school, nigga. You was
tomorrow.
Talking shit.
Behind the
tomorrow.
Bleachers, nigga. I'm going to see you tomorrow, nigga.
In class. On site.
On site.
And don't let this little discrepancy happen before 11 a.m. because it's going to be after today at school. Ain't going to be no goddamn tomorrow.
Now everybody,
today at 3 o'clock.
You don't get to practice. You don't get to wait and practice.
Lil Wayne ain't got time to fight you.
At you
no
right
time
now.
For the word
these
to get
are
out.
Honorary game bangers. These ain't regular. This ain't like
you know how many drugs
gangsters.
A nigga been on? Anybody got time to fight? Nigga,
both them niggas going to be leaning.
Gangsters. say?
Them niggas be dumb as fuck claim.
Stupid. Oh, we got a caller, y'all. We got a caller.
What's
yo.
What's your name? Where you calling from?
Where you?
Yo, this is Brian from L.A.
What's up, Brian from L.A. in the place to be? What's happening?
What up, man? Hey, that Salon CD is bomb, man. You got to get
Ah, you heard that, huh? Oh, this the homie, Brian. I recognize your voice. Hey. What's up, dog?
What up,
this nigga tried to disguise it, nigga. I know it's you. Now, you heard it, though?
Yeah, no, it's bomb. Mm-hmm. 1 through 20 is bomb, dude.
1 through 20?
Yeah, it's fire.
You be banging it in your Jeep?
Huh?
You be banging it in your Jeep or what?
Yeah, banging with my son. My son hit me to it. My older son hit me to it.
Nice.
It's nice, so yeah.
What you think about this Chris Brown? I mean, yeah, this Chris Brown Soulja Boy fight.
I'm tripping off the Soulja Boy trying to take me a Piru Blood.
What is that about, dude?
Hey, man, it cost him a lot of money to be able
That's
to
what I'm saying. He paid a lot of taxes to claim
yeah,
that.
Yeah, exactly.
You know how, like, you be close to the hood, so you, like, almost affiliated, but you ain't like, I ain't no blood, but I was close to, you know what I'm saying? Keystone Pole, that's where the bloods was at, but I can't claim that.
Nah, that nigga far away.
He walked up on the block like, what's up?
Right, like, he's even from L. He's not even from California.
Yeah, he took a plane to get close to the Bloods. Nigga use frequent flyer miles and shit. Like,
he
got
an Uber to your hood.
Yeah,
not go home to it. Like,
he got in the Uber and was like,
take me to the nearest blood hood.
Yeah.
And worst part about it, he had to text somebody for the address. Now, what's the address again?
Exactly. Put it in the jungle.
Yeah.
Do you know how to get to the fruits?
Now, which set? The ones over by USC or the ones?
You talking about the grapevine, nigga? What are you talking about?
Black. Take me to the Bompton.
And like, that should be. That, I guess that's impressive to people who are from out of town, whatever. But like those from LA, we know what the deal is. You ain't.
That ain't.
That's
cute,
who you
nigga.
Pay. No, like when you claim in a set and you was some rapper from out of town, everyone from LA know that. That's just who you paying taxes to.
We all know. You ain't got no protection.
You
fake protection.
Paying for that. That's security
homie.
Services.
It ain't protection.
That's.
Yeah, you got to make sure you good.
It's false, dude. Sure. They're getting juice for their duckies, dude. Ain't nobody going to be
security,
like, you're paying those guys. I'm not going to mess with you. No, dude, please.
That is kind of how I work in the clubs.
In theory.
Oh,
niggas,
in the club?
No, I'm saying, like, when they come to Hollywood and everything, because in Hollywood, the sets be in the little different clubs and everything like that.
In Hollywood, but nigga catch you at 7-Eleven, nigga, and not give a fuck.
What I'm saying is, when I say Hollywood, It's a lot of cats that's from these hoods that promoting. They got their nights up there. You know what I mean?
Okay.
When you pay your taxes, you know what I mean. You got a little bit of protection and a little bit of night.
That's gang.
And them niggas ain't gonna hit you up and all that bullshit.
It's rare that a nigga's from a gang that he grew up on the street and have family affiliation. Most niggas right now are to have no affiliation to the neighborhood in which they banging from. Niggas come from a whole nother side of town every day to come sit at this
put
park
me on,
and
put
then
me
go
on.
Home somewhere. So
niggas said to catch the bus home.
Yeah, can't be mad at Soulja Boy. He
doing like everybody else, huh?
He start believing his own hype. Well, he ain't even had a hype. Now he just start believing.
He made the hype.
Same. Everybody in the hood trying to get out that motherfucker. He trying to catch a bus into the
bus. Man, you're right.
Like, come on, man.
All right, we about to bust out this scene, man. This scene we about to do, it came from the movie Back to the Future, and it's the scene where little Marty McFly got in a little car and went back to the future for the first day and was looking for the doc. I'm playing the doc. Mellroz is playing Marty McFly. Ready? Lights, camera, action.
Doc!
Don't say a word.
Doc!
Don't! I don't want to know your name. I don't want to know anything about you.
Listen, Doc.
Quiet.
Doc, it's me. It's Marty.
Wait. Don't tell me anything.
Doc, you got to help.
Quiet. Okay, I'm going to read your thoughts. Let's see now. You've come a great distance.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't tell me. You want me to buy a subscription to the Saturday Evening Post?
No.
Oh, don't tell me, man. You want me to buy not a word. Quiet. Okay, let me think. Donations. You want me to make a donation to the Coast Guard Youth Auxiliary?
Doc, I'm from the future. I came in a time machine that you invented. Now I need you to get me back to the year 1985.
Oh my God. Do you know what this means? It means that this damn thing doesn't work at all.
Doc, you gotta help me. You're the only one who can help me. You know how the time machine works. It's only
time
you.
Machine? I haven't invented a time machine.
Okay, all right. I'll prove it to you. Look, here. Here's my driver's license. Look, it expires in 1987. Look at my birthday, for crying out loud. Look, I haven't even been born yet. And look at the picture of my brother, my sister, and look at me. Look at the sweatshirt, Doc. It says class of 1984. Look.
Pretty mediocre. Photography. Fakery. Look, they cut off your brother's hair.
Doc, I'm telling you the truth. Doc, you gotta believe me.
Okay, so tell me, future boy, who's the president of the United States in 1984?
It's Ronald Reagan.
The actor? And who's vice president? Jerry Lewis? I suppose Jane Wyman is the first lady.
Oh, wait, Doc.
And Jack Benny, the secretary of treasury?
Listen, you got to listen to me, Doc.
Hey, look, I got enough practical jokes, okay? Enough for one evening. Good night, future boy.
No, wait, Doc. The bruise on your head. I know what happened. You told me the whole story. You were standing on the toilet and you were hanging the clock and you fell and you hit your head on the sink and that's how you came with the flush capacitor, which makes the time travel possible.
You're fucking telling the truth. Fucker. All right. That's the end of my scene, man. We're going to take a quick break and we'll come back to it. Yay. Man, we over here, man, in the break, still talking about Obama, man.
Man.
Are we going to miss a black president?
Well, niggas 50. Least, it was a one black president. He was Obama.
He was the bestest.
He had class and style.
Served
in
two terms.
Yes, he both did. Of them to the last day. People served was crying.
It. Two terms.
He said he was crying.
He was crying watching him go. I remember I cried like a baby. He broke out to that song.
Oh, he sang some Al Green. Yeah, he sang some Al Green. Love and happiness make a brother want to do wrong, make him do right.
That's what niggas
like. I can't sing, man.
We never gonna have another president like this.
Never. Dude, that's what we were just looking at, a picture of him and Michelle hitting the bounce, like right
mid shoulder up, nigga.
They are from Chicago, though.
They are from Chicago. Shout-town.
They had to put on a hell of an act for eight years.
And he said that, too, like Michelle. He said her midnight, like Michelle, Javon, Ridges. Like, it was a black name, too. Like, from the south side of Chicago. She like, south side. She's sitting there like,
yeah, south side.
South side in the building. Front row, bitch, south side. President's wife, bitch.
Exactly. Singing some Chief Keef and shit.
All right, look. Michelle threw up.
In 50 years, y'all, first thing I'm going to say, I got about a couple words I'm going to throw out there. Picture yourself right now 50 years from now.
Shit.
First thing that comes to mind, religion.
Fuck it.
Saved.
Nothing?
Non-existent.
Hell no.
Non-existent. 50 years?
Hell no.
85, right. Fool.
In 50 years, black rights.
Non-existent.
Stagnant.
Especially stagnant if we keep accepting symbolism. Nowhere.
Yeah, it's going to be stagnant. Like, it ain't that much further from where it was in the slave day.
The Jews ain't had one president, close. But they got all the laws.
Yeah. Shit, we ain't going nowhere. That shit going to stay right where it is.
That's funny right there. They got Jesus, man.
The Jews don't fuck with Jesus.
Jesus was a Jew, man. I don't know. That's their main celebrity. All right, next. United States.
Bankrupt.
Done.
Over.
50 years. Damn, yes. Bankrupt, done, and over. Oh,
already is. Already bankrupt.
Oh, it's on its way, dude. Man. Slow grind. Rap music.
Trash.
Jazz. It'll be where jazz is now.
Oh, rap music will be trash, like jazz. Like, only the people that's dedicated to this shit.
Yeah, it's only like five good artists.
Just think about it.
50 years, it ain't even going to be one.
Think about this shit. This is what happens when it comes to jazz, rock and roll, blues, all of it. We get tired of it, and then the white folks co-opted Iggy Azalea and all
and
that
they love
shit.
It.
And then we move on and invent some new shit. So it's gonna be some new shit these kids got brewing right now.
Niggas gonna be like,
the church gonna be like, that's demonic. And then 20s after that, we gonna be digging it, and rap is gonna be what jazz is now.
To church. Exactly. Yeah, that's true.
Acquired taste.
Next one, weed.
Excellent. It'll still be striving.
Potent.
Yes. It will, weed, longevity. You know what I'm saying?
Longevity.
Longevity. We will go on forever.
And forever.
We'll keep healing. And
at
and,
your local
grocery. And it's going to be some available. Super yes. Plutonic.
Abundant. Abundant. We're going to have like 40 acres and we're going to be growing our own shit. Go pick me some weed.
Selling
grand
weed
baby.
At the liquor bank.
Yeah, exactly.
We settle for 40 plants instead of the anchors.
Get grandma some weed.
All right, next one, dating 50 years from now.
Mm. Virtual.
Virtual?
Yeah, this cat's gonna be doing that. Yeah.
She said robot. Yeah, nigga, you're gonna be dating the robot. Like, this is what I want. And the robot gonna be exactly that and shit. And ass. Dating, damn near non existent now.
Already, huh?
Yeah.
All right, let's talk about some dumb laws, man. These are laws that are still in existence that need to be removed immediately in the future.
Racism?
Dumb laws. In the state of Indiana, it's illegal for a man to be sexually aroused in public.
Damn.
Illegal.
In Indiana?
So that's our vice president coming. So that shit about to be nationwide.
Yeah, in public it's illegal. Like, you can't, you got to, I don't know what you could do.
You got to hide the Hardy.
You got to hide.
Is our
hide
vice
wood.
President.
Hide your
you
wood.
You
got to
hide
huh?
the Hardy. You got to tuck that junker under your belt.
He's stupid.
Nigga got to get a pencil sharpener for this shit. All right, next. Oral sex is illegal unless it is used as a form of foreplay in Singapore. What the fuck else could it be used for?
I don't know.
No.
Happy ending.
Or just don't. I mean, like, or gay shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
You could just do foreplay. I mean, you know. It ain't what? Nothing else to come after that, right?
Oh.
Is what they saying. Like,
oh, like you can't else. Just do it.
For the law is you got to penetrate
that.
After that.
Like, yeah, you're going to get it wet and then you're going to go in. It ain't no get wet in there. Okay,
lady
bye.
Made that law.
Yeah.
A lady made that law.
That's cool law.
Yeah,
I'm on dick tonight. Bye. Thank you.
That's illegal. We need legislation. All right, next one.
Made that law. Like, hell no. It's never going to happen again.
I need it. Two people may not kiss in front of a church in Boston, Massachusetts, to this day.
I believe that. Boston? Fuck. Shit. Hey,
Boston's on there, yeah. They got churches in Boston?
Only thing I liked that came out of Boston was them Wahlbergs. Mark Wahlberg. I love you, yeah, baby. Huh. I just want to go have a Wahlburger. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't never seen a nigga kiss in front of a church.
Don't do it in front of a church. Wahlburger. That's pretty funny.
So what about if it was a wedding?
Man,
a wedding,
dude,
you coming
get
out the joint? Boom, boom,
do it
boom.
In front of the church if
yeah,
you want to.
Yeah, do woo, it if you woo, want to. Yeah.
If you want to. Play some manics if you want to, nigga.
The next one. Obnoxious odors may not be emitted while in an elevator.
Or anywhere else in the world.
In Port Arthur, Texas.
Okay. PA in the building. That's UGK. Port Arthur, Texas. That's where Pimp
niggas
C
can't bombing. Drop no bombs in the elevator or no burps.
Port Arthur stinks. So what the fuck?
I mean, you can't get on the elevator with cologne on. Like, what the fuck?
Not if it's obnoxious.
Say,
that's true.
That's what's up. PA Pimp C real nigga.
They like they space.
Oh, no, fuck that. He'll
see. Get on there with a lean cup, though.
Nobody
say nothing. All right, next. A husband is responsible for every criminal act committed by his wife while she is in his presence.
Yes.
In the state of Utah to this day.
No objection to that.
She
could
do
go.
Any kind of shit. And you got to take the rap.
Ooh, that's a real one right there.
Woo-hoo!
Let me see what I'm going to do.
What was that about?
Are you playing? Oh, you playing? I'm going to rob this bank on your bitch ass. Rob I gotta, a bank.
You can
take
beat
that
bitch
charge.
Ass out there, though.
Take
you
playing? That you can beat charge. Ass.
Why'd you hit her? She was going to rob a bank. I ain't going down for no bullshit. Yeah. I beat her ass.
Hell
no.
Some crazy laws on the book. I got
it
one.
Is, dude. What's that?
I got one, and it's still on the books. And y'all can look it up if y'all don't believe me. State of Maryland, doctrine of exclusion. Blacks shall not enjoy the fruits of white society.
What the fuck?
You look it up.
That's everywhere. What you talking
no,
about?
No, that's a law. No, I'm saying that's a law on
that
the books.
Is,
and it's being enforced.
It's called the doctrine of exclusion.
Damn.
Look it up.
This nigga know everything.
Nah, that's real, though. That's what they want us to know. That like we still
yeah.
just like
yeah. In case you don't know,
they be like racism is a word. No, racism is y'all motherfucking laws. Goddamn.
Yeah, exactly.
We were never, you know, like we're nothing to them.
All right, this was something dumb right here, dude. A man can force any single woman to marry him if he discovers her picking her nose while sitting in traffic, sitting in a car at a traffic light. He can force her. This is in Zion, Illinois.
God.
That's some fucking...
He can afford her?
He could like
if you look, see me sitting there digging my nose at the light in Zion,
marry me.
You could be like, yeah, bitch.
Yeah, I caught you.
Because you like a bitch.
Who pushed for that lotto, dude?
Precious going to have people following her around that city.
Yeah, waiting and shit.
You know, you know who's going to be married.
Putting pepper under her nose so she can sneeze.
You know who's going to be married? A lot of white folks. Because I always see them digging in their nose. Like, what the fuck? Every time I see people on the road digging in their nose, it's white folks.
Too.
Like, yeah, they don't give a fuck either. They'll look at you.
Far reach.
They be curious ass dick. They be going on fact-finding missions.
Disgusting ass.
Tasted.
White. They don't even feel it up there. They just going on fact-finding missions. Okay. Gotta be something up in this motherfucker.
Now, I don't know the meaning of this one. It's illegal to go whale fishing in Nebraska. What the fuck?
So some people...
You can't kill a whale.
Whale fishing.
You can't kill a whale now?
In Nebraska.
Ain't no goddamn ain't oceans no whales. In Nebraska.
We can't bait a whale?
Are they talking about, like, people and shit?
No, they talking about big bitches, man.
In Nebraska, all them corn-fed chicks. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Dude, no big whale bitches, fishing. Man. Damn. All right, that's stupid.
Can't pick him up at the bar.
All right, man. My name is... Okay, so y'all know Nostradamus be coming with these predictions. My name is Mike Stradamus today. Here's my predictions about the future, and then we're going to wrap this up.
Uh-oh.
First, I feel like strippers in the future are going to be robots. Mm. And they're going to have a stipulation where they can't show you their battery.
No.
They're going to be on the pole.
That'll happen.
And I guarantee your business will plummet.
Somebody have to see that battery. If you're going to get some money out of me, I'm going to have to see that battery.
You see all these tech nerds coming down here from Silicon Valley, they might pop off with them.
They might like that.
These Google motherfuckers.
Niggas going to have. All right, look, the next one. The new iPhone will really be an iPhone. Like, this shit going to be in your eye and shit. Everything is there.
I'm not going to be able to afford that one.
Me either. I don't even want that one. I won't even put contacts in my eyes.
I'm so. Passing on that. Yeah, exactly.
I'm not going to put a phone in my eye.
I don't like reading the chart.
You know what I'm saying?
My next prediction, Northwest. Y'all know who Northwest is, right? Kanye's daughter. She's going to be the first black female president.
Next one.
Of what?
Yeah, what? Yeah.
Oh, yeah, nigga. Of I don't know. All right, next one. The Earth. Oh, this is what I really feel. I feel like the earth is going to crack and break apart when niggas get all the oil out of it. Motherfuckers take oil out the earth and don't know that's the shit that's holding this whole motherfucker together. That's my prediction.
I can't, man. You know, the Midwest, the Great Plains have sunk by over 6 inches just in the last year from all the water they got taken out.
See, man.
California has sunk over 2 feet in the last decade.
Y'all better start walking.
My daddy said, y'all going to fall off in the ocean.
Okay,
man.
When aliens land, they going to land on Crenshaw.
That's dope. Fall off in the ocean.
Yeah. They starting here. Next one. People, okay, you know how like the water's rising, it's going to be no land? People are going to have gills in 200 years. I believe it. Dude, it's going to start morphing out the mix.
Hey.
Damn, baby, that shit is kind of cool, them gills.
Hey, baby, you can I lick him. You in your gill?
You killing them gills.
Can I lick your gill, baby? All right, look.
You've been wet.
Last one, man. This is dumb. I don't even know why I'm saying it. Area 51, where the aliens are, that's going to be the new Trump golf resort.
I believe it. And no niggas allowed.
I believe it.
Right. White aliens only.
And look, the last question of the day is, would you fuck an alien?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, I gotta fuck everybody, everything. Hell, you know what I'm saying? If an alien here, I'm gonna fuck them, you know what I'm saying?
If they come, would you do it?
Yeah.
Eventually?
Hey, if it's a female one.
A female one?
That Avatar fuck shit out of blue Avatar, nigga. She bring your ass in. Hell yeah.
Is she purple?
Hopefully it's like Total Recall. She get like three titties or some shit.
Just be like, pop, 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 pop. motorboat.
I hope she give you that endless... The endless long jammy, like, here, let me just help you.
Take this.
Got all kinds of potions in
this should
thing.
Be good
look
for
look at what
hours.
I can do, right. All right, y'all, man. Dang, this hour went by super fast. I say that every week, but damn, it really did this week. So, we're going to go around the table. Tell me, give everybody your information, what you're doing next, and all that good stuff.
Mellroz Uncut, MellRoz. Follow me on all the social media sites in that fashion. And this coming Thursday, I'll be at the Moments Playhouse with Dwann B and Freeze Love for the most creative night in comedy. Straight up.
Dope. And you the most
interesting comic in the world.
Yes, man. I know your taglines. Yo, I'm Mike Robertson. Thanks for joining Mike Robertson Boulevard. We back next Tuesday. All my social media stuff is at King Mike Boogie. And that's really it.
King Mike Boogie.
And a place to be.
What's up, y'all? Precious. One Precious Comedy on all social media. Tomorrow, I'm at Cabo Wabo on Highland and Hollywood and Highland. Tomorrow
night.
Right. Yeah, I'm doing Jasmine Lee's show. And
oh, that Wednesday joint.
The
yeah.
Wednesday night. She just started it up there. And okay. So I'm doing that. And then I'm being Gardenal.
Yeah,
on the 28th with Bro Man from the Fifth Floor, Scruncho, Roy Rice, and Joe Torre was added to the show. So that's the 28th.
Damn, where's that?
Choppers Den in Gardena. At the Choppers Den.
Oh, that sounds like some motorcycle club.
East 163rd Street. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Come through, fuck with a nigga.
Bring a pistol.
I saw a lady too who doing the show and she was like, we just sold 245 tickets. I'm like, ooh, okay.
That's what's up. That's what's up.
No, I hope it's good. You know, it should be.
Dwann Brown, Dwann B on Twitter, Dwann Brown Facebook, and also sportsandthings.com. Sports, letter N, things with a Z.com. That's for all your sports highlights and shit and all kind of other things, politics and my
teams,
points of view.
Teams.
All right, you guys. So we on Morris Media Live. Y'all tune in, man, because there's some other hot shows on this channel, definitely. So y'all should check them out. It's a live YouTube page for the replays. No, not live YouTube, but a YouTube page for the replays. So check us out. Thanks to POTUS for having us tonight. And we're going to be out this joint in a place to be.
Deuces.